Hello. In this video, I'm going to go over how to format an external storage drive. I've just bought a new Samsung T7 SSD, and I'm really happy with it. However, it came pre-formatted with a different format than the one I'd like to use. First, I'll use one of the included USB cables to connect the drive to my Mac. Once the drive mounts, I'll see it on my desktop, and I can open it up. Then, if I go to File, Get Info, I'll be able to see the format. This drive came pre-formatted to the exFAT format, which would be perfect if I wanted to use it on other operating systems, such as Windows. In my case though, I only plan to use the drive on my Mac, so I'd like to change it to the APFS format. This will allow me to take advantage of a few additional features, and potentially make the drive more resilient against corruption. The drive came with a few files already on it, or if I had been using it for a while already, I might have already had some of my own files on here. When I format the drive, everything is going to be erased, so I'm going to copy these to my computer in case I need them later. Now I'm ready to format the drive. To format the drive, I need to use the disk utility, which is in the launch pad, within the other group. Opening the disk utility, I can see all the storage volumes that are attached to my Mac. My T7 SSD is listed under T7 in the external section of the left panel. Since I want to reformat the entire drive, I need to see more than just the volumes. Using the View option, I can have the sidebar show all devices. Then, I'll see the drive appear. Once I select the drive, I can click the Erase button to start selecting formatting options. There are three fields that I'll need to fill in. Starting in the Format dropdown, I see that the APFS format isn't even available. Instead, all I see are two options for macOS extended format, which is for older Mac systems, exFAT, which is the format the drive is already in, and MS-DOS FAT format, which is for Windows-compatible volumes that are 32 gigabytes or less. To be able to select the APFS format, I first need to change the scheme. Master Boot Record, which is the scheme the drive is currently in, is for compatibility with Microsoft Windows computers. Apple Partition Map is used for compatibility with old PowerPC Mac computers. GUID Partition Map, the one that I need to use, is for Intel-based and Apple Silicon Mac computers. And then going back to the format dropdown, I'll be able to choose an APFS format. There are four APFS formats listed. The two case-sensitive APFS formats are primarily used for specific situations where case sensitivity is required, such as for use with Linux systems. The first two entries, the case-insensitive variants of APFS, are the formats typically used on a Mac. The encrypted option allows the entire drive to be encrypted with a password that must be entered every time the drive is mounted. If I was going to use this drive to store sensitive files, that would be a great option. However, I don't need to encrypt this drive, so I'm just going to choose APFS. Then, all I have to do is give the drive a name. Once I click Erase, the drive will be formatted and all the data that was on it will be erased in the process. It only takes a few seconds for the formatting process to complete, and I can click Show Details to see all that was done. And that's it. Now, when I select the drive in the disk utility, I see that the scheme has been changed to GUID Partition Map. And when I select the volume, I see a format of APFS, exactly what I wanted. Closing the disk utility and going back to the desktop, I can again use File, Get Info to view the format. This time, instead of exFAT, the format is APFS. And that's all I need to do. The drive is ready to use, and I can eject it for later use. If you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Also, see the description below for more information on the Samsung T7 SSD that I used in this video. Thanks for watching.